The Philippines' foremost forensic pathologist willing to testify at the International Criminal Court in its probe of alleged extrajudicial killings in the country's anti-narcotics operations. Dr. Raquel Fortun has examined 74 remains and at least 12 bodies she recovered bullets when these should have been retrieved when autopsies are properly conducted. Fortun says it's high time for the ICC and even the international forensic community to step in.
It's a given that in forensic work, it might go to court. Why not? And yun na nga, yung nire-reassure ko doon sa mga relatives kanina na ano, at least may pinanghahawakan tayong documentation. Nakita ko sila and I documented as best as I could my findings.
Fortun, meanwhile, expressed concerns over the statement of Chief Presidential Legal Counsel Juan Ponce Enrile that he will order the arrest of ICC investigators should they enter the Philippines without government permission. The Hague-based tribunal resumed its probe on the drug war killings in the country last week.
Medyo natakot ako yung sabi, hindi sila pwedeng pumunta dito kasi ipapahuli sila. Pero sa totoo lang ko, nakakatakot. Kung natatakot kayo, isipin nyo na lang paano kami. Okay? I'm sure maraming hindi natutuwa dito sa ginagawa namin.
Only 7 Philippine police officers declined to submit their courtesy resignations as the deadline imposed by the Interior Secretary lapsed Tuesday. The Philippine National Police says the 7 senior officers are nearing retirement and they have opted to wait for their mandatory exit from the police force. Out of the 7 senior officers, 3 are generals and 4 are colonels. The call for the courtesy resignations was made by Interior and Local Government Secretary Benhur Avalos weeks ago, after a probe found that some cops were involved in the illegal drug trade.
There are 943 out of 950 third-level officers of the PNP already submitted their courtesy resignation. That currently states to 99.26%. There are 138 out of the 943 generals and 804 are colonels and 1 the inspector generals of the Internal Affairs Service.
U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin back in the Philippines for another official visit. The Pentagon chief was welcomed by U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines Mary Kay Carlson and other officials during his arrival in Manila Tuesday night. The Pentagon earlier said Austin's trip is meant to reaffirm Washington's pledge to its allies and partners to preserve a free and open Indo-Pacific. His visit comes amid tensions between Beijing and Manila due to maritime and territorial disputes in the South China Sea. Austin last visited the Philippines in July 2021 to discuss security issues.
Chinese Coast Guard presence in the West Philippine Sea more robust than ever. That's according to U.S.-based think tank Asia Maritime Transparency Initiative. It says the Chinese Coast Guard maintained near daily patrols at key features across the waters last year. The group notes Coast Guard vessels patrolled the Panatag Shoal for 344 days, up from 287. Meanwhile, days patrolled in the Ayunin Shoal increased from 232 in 2020 to 279 in 2022. The owner of a damaged Chinese vessel that was rescued in Philippine waters is asking that it be released for repairs and its crew allowed to return to their home port in China. A lawyer for the vessel's owner relayed the request during a closed-door meeting with Philippine Customs and Coast Guard officials. The lawyer claims the vessel had strayed into waters near eastern Samar after its steering mechanism was damaged near Taiwan. He also claims the crew could not present the vessel's registration certificate after it was lost in rough seas.
It was really established that the distress happened in the international seas. It happened in the high seas beyond our territorial waters and contiguous zone. Naiintindihan ko naman na sa ating batas, kailangan na sa ship yan, na sa vessel yan, yung lahat ng mga dokumento mo, requirement yan. Na-explain ko, hindi nga, iba ang nangyari, 6 meters high yung tubig. So, syempre, yung ibang mga dokumento na mawala yan.